To solve a system algebraically, that is, without graphing the two lines to see where they intersect, we use two methods. So one method is the substitution method, and our goal basically is to isolate x or y in one equation. And once we do that, we're going to plug result into other equation. Since we always have two equations, we isolate x or y in one of them, it doesn't matter which one, whichever one's easiest, and then we plug the result into the other equation. For the elimination method also, to summarize, we do it in two steps. We get both equations in standard form, and then quote-unquote match, and you'll see what I mean shortly, we match the coefficients with opposite signs and add them down. So you'll see in a second what I mean. Let's go practice a few with the substitution method, and then we'll go practice a few with the elimination method. And again, the whole time we're doing this, we're trying to see which of the three types we're going to encounter. And remember, the three types are really whether there's going to be one solution, whether there's going to be no solution with two parallel lines, or there are going to be infinitely many solutions where the two lines overlap. That's when we did it graphically, but now with algebra, and doing one of these methods, we'll be able to tell which of these three cases occur. So we're going to solve the system using the substitution method. So remember, our goal was to isolate x or y in one of the equations and plug it into the other one. So I have equation 1 and equation 2. Equation 1 already has y isolated, so I don't have to do any work. I just have to take this result and plug it downstairs into the bottom y. And when I do that, I'm going to end up with x plus, drop in the 3x, equals 4. That's going to give me 4x's total, equals 4, divide by 4, and x is equal to 1. Now I have to go find y, which means go back into either equation. 1 or 2, it doesn't matter. I'm going to go back into the cloud, because it's easier to get it there. And it looks like y is going to be 3, so these two lines do intersect. It's a consistent system, and they meet at the ordered pair 1, 3. Let's go look at part B, which is not as easy because I don't have y isolated, I don't have x isolated. This x has coefficient 2, this x has coefficient 3. I don't really want to mess with those. This y has coefficient 2, and this y has coefficient negative 1. So I would rather actually work with this one. If I take this equation 1 and solve it for y, because y seems to be the loneliest here, and whichever one is the loneliest, by that I mean coefficient 1 or negative 1, that's the one you want to isolate. So I'm going to isolate and get the y by itself, divide by negative 1. We got y equals a positive 2x minus 2. So now that equation 1 has y completely isolated, I take this y and I go plug it into the place of y in equation 2. And again, because y was easy to solve for, I chose to isolate the y. So I have 3x plus 2, drop in the cloud, which is 2x minus 2 equals 10. And now I have an equation in one variable, so we're going to go ahead and solve that. It's going to be 7x minus 4 equals 10. And it looks like we have 7x equals 14, and x is going to be 2. Now go back and find y. Doesn't matter where you go. You go back to the cloud, it's probably the easiest. You can go into equation 2, the original one, or equation 1. I'm going to go back to the cloud because it's always easiest to plug it back into the cloud. X was 2, so we're going to have 4 minus 2, which is 2. So these two lines intersect at the x-coordinate 2 and the y-coordinate 2, and it is a consistent system. Okay, part C, we're going to do the same thing. We're going to use the substitution method. I really don't like the fractions in equation 1, so I'm going to use the LCD of 4 to get rid of them. That's going to give me another equation that looks much better. That's going to be 3x plus 2y equals 20, and this guy I'm not going to change, x minus 2y equals 12. Now, since I'm supposed to use the substitution method, I go find the loneliest variable, meaning the one that has coefficient 1 or negative 1. And looking at these two, it looks like this one is the loneliest. So I'm going to take equation 2 and isolate the x because that was the loneliest. And now once I have that, I go make this into a cloud and drop it in equation 1 because I had not used equation 1 yet. Always drop it into the one that you haven't used yet. So when I do that, I have 2y plus 12 plus 2y equals 20. So once we drop that in, we simplify, combine like terms, isolate y, and we get y equals negative 2. Now I have to go find x. Again, you can go back into any of these equations that relate x and y, but I always like going back into the cloud because that's the easiest one to evaluate. So to find x, I'm going to drop in the negative 2 for the y there, and that's going to be, looks like, a positive 8. So the solution is x8y negative 2. It is a consistent system, and they meet at 8 negative 2. Okay, same direction, solve by substitution. This is equation 1, this is equation 2. So I have to either isolate x or y in whichever one's easiest, and it looks like x is loneliest right here. So I'm going to take equation 1 and isolate x. When I do that, it looks like I have 3y plus 5. And that's going to create my little cloud that I'm going to go drop into the x position in the equation I haven't used. So once I go drop that in, I get 2 times 3y plus 5 minus 6y equals 1. Now when I simplify this, I get 6y plus 10 minus 6y equals 1. And when I combine like terms, notice these guys cancel out, and I get 10 equals 1, which definitely is nonsense. This is a false statement. My variables disappeared and I got some garbage. When that happens, it means that your system is inconsistent. So I wasn't able to get an x equals something and a y equals something. It's not a consistent system. That means these lines must have been parallel. That's why I wasn't able to find an x-coordinate or a y-coordinate. It's an inconsistent system and everything disappeared. Part E again, we're going to solve the system by substitution. So T is pretty lonely and R is pretty lonely. I'm just going to take the first one and isolate the R because it's going to be quick. I just have to move the T over. So I have plus t, that should be t plus 10, it looks like. And that's going to create my little cloud that I'm going to go dump into the second equation where r is. So we'll end up with negative 2t plus 10 plus 2t equals negative 20. And simplifying gives us negative 2t minus 20 plus 2t equals minus 20. And notice these guys again disappear and I get negative 20 equals negative 20, which is definitely a true statement. So if the variables disappear and you get a true statement, that's actually a consistent but dependent system. It means that if you were to graph these two lines, they would be exactly the same line. They lie on top of each other. So I was able to get a consistent system like above, getting an ordered pair x and y. I'm able to tell when they're parallel because I get a false statement. I'm also able to tell when they're the exact same line because I get a true statement and it's a dependent system. This time we're going to solve these systems by the elimination method. So remember the first step in the elimination method was to make sure they're in standard form aligned properly. So x's are aligned, y's are aligned, and the 3 and the 1 are aligned. Then it's set to match the coefficients. Well, x's have coefficient 1, and y's have coefficient 1 and negative 1. And when I say match them, the coefficients must be exactly the same but with opposite signs, which happens to be the case for this first system. So once that happens, you automatically just add them down. And when you add them down, conveniently, these guys cancel, and we end up with 2x equals 4, and automatically we have x equals 2, then I have to go find the y value. And finding the y value, you can go into whichever one you want. Let's say I want to go into the first one. I end up with, it looks like y equals 1. So my ordered pair is 2 comma 1. Consistent system meeting at 2 comma 1. I didn't really have to do anything because the coefficients already matched up with opposite signs, so I just added them down. Let's go look at part B. Part B, the x's are nicely aligned, the y's are nicely aligned, the numbers are nicely aligned, so they're both in standard form. However, the coefficients don't match up. This is a 2, this is a 1, this is a negative 1, and that's a 2. So if I add them down, nobody cancels like it did over here. So it is my responsibility to make sure somehow the coefficients match up. Now, since these guys already have opposite signs, I'm thinking it would be really nice if I had a 2 right here, so I could have a negative 2y and a positive 2y cancel out. So if I multiply one term by 2 to get what I want, I have to multiply all sides, both sides, all the terms by 2. So because I had a 2 here and I had a negative 1 here, I conveniently multiply every single chunk by 2 and I get a new equation that's equivalent to this equation. I get 4x minus 2y equals 6. And then I keep the second guy the same because now I've reached my goal and I can add the 2 and make the y's disappear. They have exactly the same matching coefficient with opposite signs. And I'm going to end up with 5x equals 5 conveniently. And we found x to be 1. Now again, I have to go find y. Where I go to doesn't matter, either the first one or the second one, doesn't matter. I'm just going to go ahead and go into the second one by choice because I don't want to deal with negative signs. So I'm going to plug that in. X was 1. I'm going to go find y, and it looks like y is going to be negative 1. So these two guys meet at the x coordinate 1, y coordinate negative 1, a consistent system. Okay, part C, again solved by the elimination method. Coefficients of x's don't match up, coefficients of y's don't match up, so it is my responsibility to make either the x's match up or the y's match up. I'm going to go ahead and think, well, if I can get both of them to look like their LCD or least common multiple 6, that would work. So I'm going to change both equations. I'm going to multiply the top, all terms by 3, and if that's going to make this a 6, then I'm going to need a negative 6 down here. So I'm going to multiply everybody down here by negative 2 to achieve matching coefficients, opposite signs. So once I multiply the 3 through, I get this. Once I multiply the negative 2 through, I get that. And now I have exactly what I wanted. I wanted things to go away, and the x's do go away. And I end up with only 1y equals negative 2, and I don't really have to do anything more other than go find x. Where you want to go back up to here or the original problem doesn't matter. I'm going to go back to the first one, again by choice. And I found y to be negative 2. And by plugging the y back into the first equation, the way I chose it to be, ends up giving me a x value of negative 2 as well. So I get a consistent system with x coordinate negative 2 and y coordinate negative 2 as well. Again, for all these problems, we didn't graph any of them. All we did was either use substitution or elimination to find where they meet. And if the variables disappeared and I got a false statement, that told me that it was an inconsistent system, parallel lines. Or if the variables disappeared and I got a true statement, that told me that it was a dependent system, which was consistent and the lines were on top of each other.